comes to mind.
First,
New Testament, Sunday morning, it comes to mind. Yes, Easter, first Easter Sunday morning. Mary, and to me, how she kept her son. Let's recapture God's Sabbath for our life and God's Sabbath for our world. That's what New Testament Sabbath is. He gave the whole world a day of worship and rest. Let's capture it for ourselves. Let's go through in your life. Let's see how much of it we can retain and give to Him. When we recover our Sunday, we recover many things in our life. This was how Methodism was born. And they said, Sunday best. In dress and in everything else. Sunday lunch was so special. Father and me always did it as an act of worship. First thing in the morning, they thought Sunday worship. Lord Jesus, today is Sunday, and we want to come.
Reverence and
sanctify God. Help us to be in this uncertainty. Secondly, let's bring that family prayer time to the reverence of God. Ideally in the morning, before you go to work, at least 10 minutes. 30 minutes would be such a divine luxury. At least 10 minutes. Father, lay hands upon the mother and children and claim your place as the priest of the home. And in the night, your children will see as they fall asleep, kneeling by their bedside. This would be their most persistent memory in all their days at home. Lord, tonight I am praying to recover family prayer time. And Father, reading scriptures as instructed, prescribed in Deuteronomy chapter 8. Lord, make our fathers the priest of the home. Fathers, will you please make this covenant? Make this your honor, duty, privilege, highest privilege, molding of your children's spirit by your words and by your example. Lord, I'm claiming fathers in this congregation to see their noble career as the call of God in their life, as the priest at home. If you have been amiss, some other career is precedent in your mind, in your timetable, in your pursuits and energies, let's ask forgiveness. Let's ask forgiveness. Fathers, get back to your high heavenly call to lead the home, shepherd the home. Today Roshan is going to bring the message. It was an excellent message in the morning. Hiranti was due to bring the message, but it had such a telling effect in the morning. We felt he should bring it to the evening congregation also. And when I was praying with him, I saw this thick shepherd cloak that the shepherd wraps the newborn lambkins coming. That's the melting heart the Lord will give us during his message. But we are recovering the father's shepherd. Will you have some godly sorrow? Some conviction that this is your rightful place at your son's bedside, at your daughter's bedside, every day, every night. Thank you, Holy Spirit. God, at this moment we are restoring two things: your people, reading scriptures, and your people, keeping the good over family prayer time. Let's pray for the third thing, that the scripture reading, the formative habit of scripture reading, scriptures will wash your mind. Beloved, if not, our own thoughts will rule us. Our hearts, Jeremiah 17 verse 5 says, untrustably, unreliably deceptive. And we need the reason of the scripture, washing of the scripture, rule of the word by daily reading. I can feel it agonized this week that so many homes don't have the Father's voice reading the scripture. Then the thief comes to steal, kill and destroy, and at this moment, Father in heaven. We are recovering the Father's voice in the home, reading scriptures into the hearts of the children, into the heart of the family, over their heads, the word that watches and goes with them when they roam, the words that keeps them when they are asleep, the word that awakes them early in the morning. Thank you, Holy Spirit. We want to recover the reverence of this Sunday. Offer you the excellence of our effort to you, to you, to you. Forgive us from the idolatry. Save us from the idolatry of giving our excellence to another God, another thing, another pursuit, a different seal. Forgive us. Thank you, Holy Father. Walk into every home now. The prayer we have prayed would be written upon the doorposts and the lintel of front door, every room, and over the back door. Shall we say together, no losses in my home. No loss of reverence, no loss of affection, no loss of respect from children to parents, no loss of finances, no loss of health. I have written the rule of your word upon every doorpost and every lintel of my home, every door, every window, protected, sealed by the blood. Secured by the word, protected by the Holy Spirit, in Jesus' name.